Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and hello everyone. My name is Abdul Karim alias from University Science Malaysia. In this video, I'll be talking about this topic, converting traditional MCQs, multiple choice questions, to scenario-based questions. Well, there's been a lot of discussion and interest about open book exam lately, simply because everyone is, you know, all the courses are going online and we do assessment. So people are looking into alternative assessment, including examination that normally we do as face-to-face invigilated exam. So now for the online course, how do we design the exam in the form of open book exam so that, you know, we can avoid the issue of cheating or worrying so much about students copying or cheating. So this topic I think would be very relevant and very timely and also very important. And many people ask whether we can use MCQ for open book exam. Well, I think it can be used for open book exam, provided we have to kind of redesign it from the traditional MCQs. What is traditional MCQs? So there's something that maybe you want to understand. Well, if you want to read more or to understand more about the merits and demerits of so-called traditional MCQs, I have one article here from Faculty Focus website, one of my favorite website. This article is about multiple choice tests, revisiting the pros and the cons of so-called traditional MCQs. I think one of the common arguments on using MCQs, most of the MCQs are designed to focus more on testing the low order thinking, you know, in terms of the cognitive level in the Bloom taxonomy. So most of the MCQs are said to be, you know, focus more on recalling the facts, which is the first and the second level in Bloom taxonomy. But of course, there are some advantages or some positive aspect of MCQs. For example, using MCQ, we can prepare a question that can cover a broad range of topics in the syllabus, you know, in the course. Whereas for essay question, maybe, you know, we can write, we can have like 3 to 4 or 5 the most questions, and it may not cover, you know, the range, the whole range content of the syllabus. So when we design MCQs for open book exam, we need to design the question in such a way that it will get the students, engage them in the higher order thinking skill, in terms of the cognitive engagement or the cognitive level. There is probably on the application and above in the Bloom taxonomy. So one of the strategies to design MCQs of this type is by using a scenario based type of question. So this is the main subject that I want to talk about in this video. Okay, so let's look at the reason why scenario based question would be best or would be one of the format that you want to use if you want to use MCQs for your open book exam. So converting multiple choice questions to scenario based questions can increase the difficulty level, measure higher level thought, and provide relevant context. So I'm going to give you some examples of how we can convert or transform the so-called traditional type MCQs, which focus mainly at the low order thinking level, to a higher level of cognitive, higher order thinking by using scenario based. Okay, so let's look at these questions. What kind of thinking is required by each type of question here? By the way, I want to acknowledge that The example that I'm using in this video are taken from Kathy Moore. Kathy Moore is one of the person who is doing a lot of work in scenario-based learning design. Yeah, so this is taken from a website, Action at Work, and this is taken from the article written by Kathy Moore. Okay, so that's the acknowledgement. So look at this question. Yeah, what kind of thinking is required by each type of question here? Which of the following is the most secure way to carry sensitive data? A, on a laptop. B, on a USB drive chained to your wrist. C, on a CD titled The Chipmunks Sing Disco Duck. Okay, three options there. Then, when the students answer the question, maybe these are probably the online quiz. Yeah, we are talking about doing this online. So when they answer the quiz, they get a feedback. Feedback for incorrect answer is incorrect. If the student answer wrongly, the feedback that they will get is incorrect answer, incorrect, or and try again. That's all. Okay. So what do you think of the kind of thinking required for this type of questions? Okay, let's look at this one. So this is a so-called traditional MCQ, and this one is what we call as mini scenario with some feedback, but the feedback is correct and incorrect feedback. The same question, but the same options, but here the question is written slightly different way compared to this one. Okay, here Bob wants to work on the salary data at home. He has a long commute on the train. How should he carry the data with him? Notice that Bob wants to work on salary data. It doesn't say anything about the sensitivity of the data, the confidentiality of the data. This one, the original form, to carry sensitive data. It mentions specifically, explicitly, that the data is sensitive. But here, it says that the data is actually a salary data. Think about it. What kind of thinking is required by each type of question here? Same option, but the feedback is still the same. If the student's answer choose a wrong answer, the feedback is incorrect. Try again. Okay, let's look at this one, the third version of these questions. In this case, this is using a so-called mini scenario with showing feedback. Okay, now Bob wants to work on the salary data at home. He has a long commute on the train. How should he carry the data with him? Same option, but now looks at the feedback. The feedback for A, if the student choose A, is on his laptop. Bob falls asleep during the commute and a thief steals his laptop and sells the data. Try again. Not just try again, but there's some explanation there. If the student chose the option A, if the student chose the option B, on a USB drive chained to his wrist, then the student will get this feedback. Bob falls asleep during the commute. A thief sits next to him, plugs his USB drive into his laptop while Bob is unconscious, and later sells the data. Try again. Still a wrong answer, but at least now the students would now understand more about why the option B is wrong. The right answer here, the correct answer, is C. So if the student answers C, yes, correct. But now the students would know and understand why the answer is correct. The student might probably just guess the answer and the student get lucky. But maybe he or she doesn't really understand. So here the explanation actually give the reason why the answer is correct. So Bob falls asleep during the commute and thief steals all his belongings. The thief breaks the city into pieces in disguise and no one ever sees the data. This is the best choice. This is the example of from this simple way of so-called we write the question into a so-called using a mini scenario and mini scenario with some good feedback for the students. Now let's analyze this one. For these questions, this version 1, the original one, the quiz question asks learners to simply regurgitate the facts without giving any context. It just straight away asks the questions without giving any context. Okay. The second one here, we give a short or mini scenario here, a brief scenario, same option, and the feedback is also very simple, incorrect, try again. So in this version, version 2 here puts the facts into realistic context, but directly tells the learner when they have made an incorrect choice. Okay, so there's some context here, but still the feedback is there, but very simple feedback. It may not be very helpful still, but at least there is some context where the students would try to think about in this, given the context here, the salary data. Okay, the salary data. Oh, this salary data must be a sensitive data, so this must be protected at all cost. So that's the context. Okay. The third question here is even better because it includes context and lets learners to conclude on their own from the results that they have made an incorrect choice. So when they choose an incorrect choice, they now understand why the choice is incorrect. The results also show why that choice was not the best one. Why the choice A is not the best one. The reason is given here. Why choice B is not the best one. The reasons are given here. But choice C is the best one. And that's also the reason why it is the best one, because the data was kind of camouflaged in the form of a CD, and it's camouflaged with the title, "The Chipmunks Sing Disco Duck." So the thief never, and they thought that, oh, this CD doesn't contain useful things that of valuable, so they just throw away. So basically the student actually learn more from this kind of mini scenario based questions. So when we design open book questions, when we use scenario, the student would have to really think very carefully and very, very critically and try to see the context of the questions. So they will be engaged in a very deep thinking in order to identify the right answer for the questions. Let's look at more example here. Okay, compare this scenario-based question here. Question 1. A member of your team is often an hour late to work on Monday mornings. So that's a scenario. What should you do? A. Ask the team member why they are late. B. Refer the team member to the employee assistance program for counseling. C. Dock the team member's pay for the missed hour of work. So if you are the HR manager or the boss, you have to make a decision here. So scenario-based learning is actually where you are given the scenario, and based on the knowledge that you have, based on your experience, based on the facts that you have learned, how should you act in this situation? Okay. Compare this question and the same questions, but in the expanded scenario-based type. So we have a longer one here, but basically this is the scenario that now the students have to read very carefully and try to identify and understand the scenario, the context, and find the clues here. Okay, so Jake has worked on your team for 2 years. So there's some facts there in terms of duration, how long Jake has worked. Maybe it has some implication here. In the last 2 months, he's arrived an hour late on most Mondays. He doesn't seem as cheerful. Notice that this all information that is needed to guide, to help the manager maybe to make a decision here. As he used to be, and a couple of times you have noticed that his eyes appear bloodshot. You are pretty sure he's married. And you remember signing a congratulations card for his new baby about 7 months ago, but you haven't heard anything since then. You ask Jake to come into your office after lunch. When he arrives, his eyes look bloodshot again and he fidgets with his hands. How do you start the conversation? Okay, there's a choice A, choice B, the choice C. So really, this type of questions, of course it looks more wordy, but this really get the students to really think and try to understand the scenario and the context and the facts given. And this is where they have to go to the higher level of cognitive engagement here. Critical thinking, analyzing, evaluating, and try to apply what they have learned before, maybe in the previous chapter or the chapter about how to manage the people's emotion, or the knowledge that they have learned from the chapter on interpersonal skill, all these things. Yeah, then and analyze the situation and then analyze the options that he has here, how to start the conversation. Okay, so now if we analyze now, you know, this type of question compared this previous one here. Okay. This one compared to this one and this one. So here the scenario given here is more subtle and more realistic. And this would actually, this type of questions, if we use this in the training program for the new managers, it will train the manager on how to phrase the difficult questions to ask, to have a conversation with the worker. And the characters in this question has names, Jake, for example, you know. And cues are given, hints are given, so that the manager can evaluate the situation, the person in terms of the emotional stability and so on. So cues are given, the bloodshot eyes, you know, mata merah, the change mood, for example, he doesn't seem as cheerful. And the correct answer is not obvious. The correct answer here is not obvious. This is type of so-called scenario-based question, which if we can design in the context of your subject matter for the open book exam, it really it's not that we want to make it difficult for the students, but really we want to get the students to really think about the question, and where the answer is not obvious, they have to really engage in their critical thinking, problem solving skill, and analyze the situation based on the facts given. Based on the facts given, analyze the situation, apply the knowledge that they have from, you know, what they have learned in the course, or if this is a scenario in the workplace from the experience that they have, previously, all this put together collectively to identify the right answer in this case. This is what I mean by transforming the so-called simple MCQs, which basically focus more on the low level thinking, into MCQ that actually test the students on the higher level or the higher order thinking in the Bloom taxonomy. Okay. Example 3 here is taken from Christy Tucker. Christy Tucker is another educator who is she's an instructional designer. He specializes in scenario-based learning. So this example is taken from her, from the website. So let's say the example here, the scenario. Let's say you are creating training. You are creating training for managers on how to provide reasonable accommodations for employees. You drafted a set of traditional multiple choice questions as a quiz for the end of the course, but they are all very low level. You want to improve the quality of your assessment with some scenarios. Okay, so this is one example here. These are original questions, a simple kind of traditional MCQ. What reasonable accommodation is recommended for a temporary disability or medical issue affecting work? So these are the options A, B, C, D. Okay. So I give you a few seconds, maybe 10 seconds to read the option here. A, B, C, D. Okay. Now, how do we convert this question into a scenario-based question? How do we convert this low order thinking questions to a higher order thinking questions using scenario-based approach? Okay, let's look at let's analyze this question. Okay. First, of course, we want all the questions be aligned to the learning outcome. So ask the question, does your assessment align to the learning outcome? If not, rewrite it. In this example, the objective is the learner will follow the procedure for providing reasonable accommodation. Okay, that's the objective. The objective of the learning, one of the learning objective of the course is the learner will follow the procedure for providing reasonable accommodation. So does this question align to this learning objective? The question is actually the traditional low-level MCQ, this assess recall. The objective for this course actually requires application. The learner will follow the procedure for providing reasonable accommodation. Therefore, the question must be also designed, the MCQ must be designed at the level of application. Yeah? So this question should be rewritten at a higher level. And this is one example of the same question just now written for the higher level using the scenario. So the scenario here is Simon, a graphic designer on the team you manage, is having a surgery. He requested 2 weeks time off to recover after his surgery. How should you respond? So this is a context. The scenario that gives the context and giving some facts in order to enable the student or the person to evaluate the situation and therefore coming up with or be able to decide which option is the best in this scenario. So here one method to revise the question is to add a scenario to introduce the choices. This provide context. It shifts the question from just recalling information to using that information to make a decision. Yeah, to make a decision which option would be the best choice. The scenario introduces the questions. Yeah, the scenario is actually introduces the questions. The choices are essentially the same as before, but now it's a decision about how to work with an employee you manage. Instead of measuring recall, these questions measures if learners can apply the reasonable accommodations policy. So, finally, for this video, I just want to summarize what constitutes an ideal scenario. If you write MCQ type, MCQ using the scenario-based type questions, yeah. So, what constitutes an ideal scenario for an MCQ? It represents a real case commonly seen in daily practice. It is carefully written, with no ambiguity. It leaves the examiner with no doubt about the key information provided. It is an integral part of the questions. It provides the opportunity to construct several questions with specific educational objectives covering issues related to the case. And this is an infographic from this shift here. Basically, it shows the five steps, or five consideration how to build an effective scenario-based course. First, identify your target audience and their needs. Second, identify learning needs and outcomes. Third, choose a situation for a scenario. Then select the app scenario structure, and you can use you can write a scenario-based kind of questions that is focused on skill-based, problem-based, issue-based, speculative, or game-based. You can find out more about the different types of scenario-based questions. These five different types. Yeah, maybe I will have another video on this one to explore more on the different types of scenario-based structure for the MCQs. Yeah, for the MCQs using this approach. So that's all for this video. I hope you have got some ideas how you want to convert or transform your so-called traditional MCQs that test more on the low order thinking to a scenario based type MCQs that focus more on testing the higher order thinking and probably more suitable for open book exam. Thank you very much. Abdul Karim alias from me, Abdul Karim alias, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and see you in another video. Thank you. Bye.